fighting Joe Schmo instead of fighting a rematch with Devin Haney.
Yeah, it's going to come down to a number of things. It's the network. I don't know what the deal structure is, but it's. I think, you know, we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens.
It's the guy.
Best jab in boxing?
Got one of them. That elite jab. He's the guy who's going to move up to 47 because he's 5'9 and got long arms. That's a problem for all these guys.
All of them except two.
Except Rolly Romero and Tank Davis?
Mm-hmm. Are those two?
What?
Rolly. Rolly gets past the jab?
Listen, I'm not just saying this, but if... I want to say this the right way.
Yeah, go ahead.
Time. Preach.
If you'll have to have more to be rolling.
Oh, more than just the power.
No, you're gonna have to have more than a jab.
Oh, more. Oh,
and I'm not. You're gonna have to have something to keep rolling off of. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? You're gonna have to have something to keep him off.
Because
I don't even want to talk about things that can't
happen. Yeah. Man,
anything's possible, Leonard.
Yeah, I was just about to say.
It's like, I mean, we have to, a lot of times people say things and then it's not, things aren't realistic. You know, it's like those mythical matchups. You know, things have to make sense. Jango fight anybody. He'll fight anybody.
I want to fight, I want all the belts. You know,
And you let it be known, you'll fight Ryan Garcia, Teofimo. What do you think of a potential unification with Devin Haney?
As of right now, I'm going to enjoy it. Tank got a long training camp. And we really want to enjoy this victory. As soon as a fight is over, the first 10 seconds, who do you want to fight? Tank is the top dog.
You know what I'm talking about? Tank. By the time we talk about him, David did super good. But I have to tell you this right here. He did super good. But guess what I did?
You put one of your fighters against
Devin Haney?
Yes, I did.
Who'd you put, Devin Haney?
You better believe it.
How did that go?
How did it go? Man, that don't even ask the question. it ain't worth asking because it was a one-way deal. It only one man controlled it.
And that was Devin Haney.
Again, Tank is the man. Anywhere he goes, he's the guy. He's the guy. And with him moving to 135, he instantly becomes the guy that beat in the division. Period. Tank is a world champion. He's nobody's manager. Anyway, you look at it, you say this, Tank ain't nobody's manager. We call it all the shots in anything we do. Any and everything we do. All these guys get in line. Nobody's telling us what to do. We're doing things the way we want to. Who's in line? Everybody's open season. Any and everybody can get it at 35 and 30. Yeah, thanks. Moving to 135, again, it's just another opportunity for him to do something different. You know, think outside the box. He wants to be a multi champion in different weight classes. And it's another great opportunity. The tender age of 25. He ain't going nowhere. If they say this guy's the top guy, meaning the fans, and we're not just talking about the small little circle of boxing fans. The fans across the world. You know, what Tank brings is exciting.
Around the world. Around the world.
Any man in the world. I'm not the best. I'm not the guy you're willing to fight the best. And I will stand in the best. I claim the best.